Michael, what Ray is saying, I mean, that is scripturally accurate. That
oh, yeah.
God literally blinded people from being able to have faith in him, perfect faith in Christ, because if they would have been able to have faith, if they would have been able to believe before the cross, the Bible says they would have been saved.
Absolutely.
And so God, see, here's the problem, folks, is that we see these scriptural passages, and by scriptural we mean the law, the Psalms, and the prophets. We're not talking about the New Testament writings, but we see also things in the teaching of Christ that happens before the cross, and a lot of miracles and a lot of stuff that is going on, like Ray says, a supernatural stupidity. I remember I did the teaching at the Second Gospel Revolution Convention in Houston called Miraculous Condemnation. The purpose behind what Jesus was saying, what the acts that were happening, was to bring people to the end of themselves. But Michael, after the cross, as Ray was saying, when Yeshua goes to the cross, when he's raised from the dead, when he ascends to heaven, God has ceased not only to
yep.
deal with humanity as he did in what we call the Old Testament, what Yeshua and the disciples called the Scriptures. Everything was completed at the cross, but not only that, but now our eyes have been opened, and yet people mm-hmm. continue out of their own volition and out of the influence of religious leaders
yes.
to approach Christ, to approach God, to approach themselves, and to approach each other the same way they did before the cross. What a pity. What a shame that
yeah.
is.
Absolutely, because like Ray is saying, I mean, you know, we've got a reason why these people could be so stupid. We've got a reason. God put stupid on them. And he put stupid on them to bring about the fullness of the cross. They were to remain stupid. They were stupid, and they were supposed to remain stupid. And the prophet Isaiah said in Isaiah, it's quoted in chapter 12 of John, actually, in the same book, that God blinded their eyes and stopped their ears so that they could not believe and be healed through their belief. You just don't realize how important unbelief is to redemption.
Yep.
Unbelief is the key to redemption. Belief
wow.
is not the key to redemption. The redemption of the world, the key to the redemption of the world was unbelief, and to declare all to be in unbelief, and that only God himself could have this sort of faith. Jesus literally mocked people by trying to describe faith. And my gosh, you and I both, Glenn, quoted this and tried to do it then, when it's obvious all Jesus is doing is trying to explain to us, you ain't got it, and you ain't never going to have it. Jesus said, if you had faith as a grain of mustard seed, and we go into the detail, mustard seed, the teeny, 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 tiniest, tiniest, little, tiniest seed on the face of the planet. But Jesus said, if you have faith as just a grain of mustard seed, you could pick this tree up and throw it in the river. You could pick this mountain up and throw it in the sea. All you'd have to do, if you had faith at all, you could move this mountain. That's what faith does. Humans don't have it.
I'll tell you what the problem with that. See, Michael, the problem with that, and everyone, I'm speaking in sarcasm right now. The problem with that is you're taking me out of the equation. Duh, dummy. The whole point. And I'll say it again, if it required you to believe, those people sitting there watching him do the stuff should have believed it right then and there. There's no way to go around that. They were.
I love it, Ray. Michael, we were doing our pre-show preparation today, folks, and Michael and I were talking about this, and Michael. What in your and Ray's study did you find about what Yeshua said to people before the cross? Now, folks, you got to remember, this is all before the ultimate sacrifice. What did he say to people, Michael, who told him that they believed in him?
He told them they were of the devil. Repeatedly.
Like, how did he say it? How did he tell them?
Just like that. Let me take one of the situations. Right after he fed the multitudes, after he opened the eyes of the blind boy, and then they required that, you know, they go talk to his mother and father, they ask him, and like Ray said, they had supernatural stupid on them, because they asked the blind man, how did you get healed? And even the blind man, they asked him again. He said, I told you once. He said, if I told you once and you didn't listen to me, why should I think you're going to listen the second time? And so this was constant throughout this encounter with Jesus and his miracles.